then pushes once in his $1,000+ Nike Jordan 1 Retro Highs by Fragment Design collab kicks before gracefully sliding nearly 2 full seconds on a curbside nollie frontside nose blunt. Hello, and thank you for joining another episode of Dumb Data, where we break down the numbers so you don't have to. In this breakdown, we'll take a look at the 2020 Tokyo Olympic gold medalist Yuto Horigome's Spitfire video, filmed and edited by Kevin Perez. Before we do that though, a topic related to this part dropping needs to be addressed. Tis the season in the skateboarding world where 2 frontrunners are in contention for the prestigious Skater of the Year, aka SOTY accolade, from the 40-plus-year-old industry mainstay Thrasher magazine. Before Yuto dropped the Spitfire part, Mark Suciu released a 4-plus-minute Adidas part, Blue Dog, and then, followed by the 3-minute Habitat video called Curve, and then a 5-minute Spitfire part. And at the time of putting together this edit, he dominated roughly 6 to 7 minutes of Justin Albert's 3rd installment of the recently dropped Flora series, totaling somewhere around 27 minutes of total part footage that's been released in the span of less than 3 months. Mark Suciu's footage productivity is unmatched this year, and it might be the most skate footage anyone's released in such a short time frame. To give some context as to the significance of how much footy Suciu spit out in the last few months, last year's SOTY, Mason Silva, notably dropped 4 parts in 2020. 2 real parts, 1 Nike SB part, and a surprise Spitfire part, all of which were heavy, and added up to about 16 to 17 minutes of footage. Suciu's 4 parts released in 2021 have almost 10 minutes more cumulative runtime than Mason's parts, showcasing that Mark is undoubtedly a candidate this year for SOTY. Whether Thrasher orchestrates the hype intentionally to get the buzz going by handpicking 2 standout rippers for the year, or the phenomenon organically occurs where 2 skaters bubble to the top of the conversation about who's the best, the scenario in 2021 is no different.
Tape record, put it on YouTube, put it wherever you'd like.
It's obvious that Mark will go down as one of the most prolific skaters of his time, producing more content than his contemporaries, including Yuto Horigome. My life be like, being the first ever Olympic gold medalist in street skateboarding is the argument used as the sole reason for those advocating Yuto deserves the SOTY title this year, and his Spitfire part, which we're about to dissect trick by trick, only further supports his case. Skateboarding can be just as much of an art form as it is a tangibly measurable activity, and in my opinion, who will win is based on what will help Thrasher the most as a business. Mark Suciu has unfortunately been in this unenviable position of getting snubbed from the SOTY title back in 2019, even after releasing one of the longest single parts, Verso, another film by Justin Albert, when Argentinian Milton Martinez dropped the multi-sponsor-backed Demolición, which opened with a posthumous clip of Thrasher's former editor-in-chief, Jake Phelps, and featured the SLS trick of the year, the unfathomable kickflip into the sunset car wash bank. Watching Mark Suciu's skating, while at a skill level much higher than I can hope to achieve in this lifetime, is somehow relatable, and the music in his parts have a nostalgic aura that takes me back to when I was a kid having fun skating with my friends. When you see the parts that made SOTYs out of Milton Martinez, Mason Silva, and what I'm guessing will soon be Yuto Horigome, the message comes across pretty clear that these dudes are dropping hammers no one else will likely be able to replicate. Thrasher's vibe is about putting your life in danger with death-defying stunts, and Mark Suciu's skating doesn't necessarily lack those characteristics. It's more so that he has to compete with skaters in years where historical shit goes down. And at the end of the day, Yuto rocked Thrasher gear in the most noteworthy clips of his Spitfire part. Not that wearing Thrasher swag in your part is the prerequisite to getting SOTY, but you'd be hard-pressed to find Suciu rocking a Thrasher tee in his videos, let alone a gnarly Supreme Thrasher collab hoodie. It's almost like if Mark released Verso in 2018, he might have had a better chance winning SOTY over Tyshawn Jordan. or if he dropped his four 2021 parts in 2020, he might have beat Mason. If you're asking me, both Mark and Yuto deserve a lot of recognition for what they've achieved this year, but when it comes specifically to Thrasher SOTY, you can't help but think that someone in Yuto's camp strategically made sure Thrasher gets repped in the Spitfire part. What about the timeline of how Mark and Yuto's skating played out in 2021? Before any of Mark's parts were dropped, April Skateboards posted the Yuto Show on their YouTube channel in late June, and Thrasher Magazine featured a Nollie 270 nose slide on the cover of the June issue, which actually shows Yuto skating a different board than the clip from him doing the same trick in the April part. 1 month later, in late July, Yuto around and wins himself the gold medal in the first ever men's skateboarding street final in the Tokyo Olympics. Understandably, we don't see much more skating-wise from Yuto after the Olympics, apart from some IG clips with Lil Wayne.
My slam Yuto, you already know. Man, what?
Which is where Mark comes in and sits down with the 9 Club for an interview in August 2021. In his interview, Mark Suciu admits to knowing why he didn't get SOTY over Milton Martinez in 2019.
Who won the 2019 Skater of the Year?
Milton.
Milton.
Oh my God. How dare you forget?
Listen.
Well, because that was the funny part, right? It was like it was you and Milton going for it. Was like that was who everyone was looking at. It was you two, and your guys are such different types of skateboarders.
Yeah,
and I was like, I really wonder how this is gonna turn out.
Right.
And then you had that part drop, and then also Milton's coming out. What did that feel like being in the runnings and then seeing another person's part come out? Be like, oh, that dude's definitely got it.
Like, yeah, it was wild. I mean, like that part was. Nuts.
Yeah. Yes, it was.
It was nuts.
Yes, but your part was nuts as well.
Thank you.
For sure.
Definitely. Yeah, but it was kind of like you can tell, kind of that had Thrasher written all over it. It was on a shirt.
Yeah. You know?
As we touched on previously, Mark drops Blue Dog, Curve, and the Spitfire part, which as of today have accumulated nearly 700,000 YouTube views. Yuto pulls a Milton Martinez and reminds everyone that he's not done up the streets, and drops the Spitfire part about 2 weeks after Mark's.
Bruh.
But then, Mark's Flora 3 part gets posted 2 days after Yuto's Spitfire part, which includes a final rail destruction montage that can't be taken lightly. Will Yuto's part prevent Mark Suciu from another Thrasher SOTY award? Time will tell, and whoever wins deserves it, but for now, let's take a look at Yuto's Spitfire part and dive into some data. Lines. 14 tricks are featured in Yuto's 6 Spitfire lines, and the only one with more than 2 tricks is line number 3, where we're transported to Abraham Lincoln High School in Lincoln Heights, Los Angeles, right by the intersection of North Broadway and Lincoln Avenue. Yuto starts with a backside wall ride to flat ground nollie flip 1-2 punch, then pushes once in his $1,000+ Nike Jordan 1 Retro Highs by Fragment Design collab kicks, before gracefully sliding nearly 2 full seconds on a curve side nollie frontside nose blunt, then gives us a better view of his $100+ Air Jordan by Fragment Design men's lifestyle t-shirt and Carhartt work pants in the lead up to his backside 360 down the 8 stair. The first of 5 lines with 2 tricks takes place in San Francisco, starting with Yuto popping a nollie frontside kickflip at the run-up to the Dolores Park 10 stair, then switch backside heel flipping to the beat, and landing with the on-trend hoodie almost falling off stees on the rollaway. Getting academic on our Yuto teleports to the University of Southern California and has no time to take off his Carhartt puffer jacket while squeezing in this nollie frontside 50-50 down the 16 set behind McKibben Hall, then ollieing down this 3 set on the Health Sciences campus before the Popos give the gang the boot. Next, Yuto heel flips upstairs, adorned in a Thrasher Times Supreme collab hoodie, and then perfectly nollie big heels a 10 set like he's on his way to the gas station to grab a yerba mate. Showing love to the ledges, Yuto gets his money's worth out of the Fragment Design Jordans with a nollie frontside 180 crook, and without a single push in sight, situates himself for a P-Rod signature switch flip back tail, but oh damn, he gives us the shove out too! Checking 2 more boxes off of the skateboarder to-do list for the final line of the part, we get a long switch pop shove it gap in San Francisco to switch hill bomb down Greenwich Street past the intersection of Stockton. And after some speed wobbles, Yuto decides to make a 40-mile-an-hour revert to regular before skirting past a Buick sedan. Single shots. The first of the 9 single shots in Yuto's part is what Thrasher and the rest of the internet believe to be an NBD, aka a never-been-done trick. With this inconceivable nollie backside 180 alley-oop switch Smith down the lower Shoal Canyon Park 8-stair handrail located in Glendale, California. Almost 10 years ago, Girl's Pretty Sweet video depicted Corey Kennedy doing a somewhat similar trick, a frontside half cab feeble down the same rail, which was crazy then and still is to this day. Corey's ender is a close comparison to what Yuto achieved on this rail, but the latter trick is hands down more difficult. Objectively speaking about the difficulty, Yuto needs to roughly turn an extra 90 degrees over the rail to lock into the switch Smith. Whereas for Corey's trick, as soon as his back trucks are over the rail, he locks toe side into the front feeble, and therefore doesn't need to contort himself as much as Yuto. This isn't even mentioning the fact that Corey's locking into a regular front feeble, which is not as difficult as a switch front Smith. Before this little monologue gets misconstrued as an opportunity for me to talk about Corey's trick, let me be clear. A frontside half cab feeble down an 8-stair is gnarly. Corey's ender here is being used as evidence that Yuto is ahead of his time and is progressing faster than most, if not every skateboarder out there today. On top of the sheer danger Yuto's NBD entails, he locks into the Smith like it's regular, making this stunt seem simple. And that's the first trick of the Spitfire part. The next single shot is an immaculate pop shove it down the East LA College 13 set. Who wants to simply kickflip down a 10 set when you can throw a manual into the mix? Looks like Yuto's down for it. Yuto doesn't just skate stairs and rails and ledges. He can manhandle a mega-sized Jersey barrier with a frontside hurricane, all while stylishly plugging a pair of $500+ Nike SB Dunk J-Pack Chicagos. A nollie frontside heel flip up and over this rail to 8-foot drop at the Hollywood Sikh Temple finds Yuto rolling into the street by the intersection of Finley and Vermont Avenue. Pairing his earlier pop shove it huck, Yuto needs to weave his way past security before completing the union with a frontside shove down the Grand Avenue Plaza 14 set near 3rd Street in downtown LA. Heading where I would guess is north from SoCal, another combo and Thrasher photo op is depicted when Yuto switch bombs into the steep bank of crust after a 180 fakie manny. The penultimate single shot is when Yuto steps to the iconic Clipper Street hubba in San Francisco, rolling away from a nollie heel backside nose slide 270 shove out. These surprises, like the shove out of an already epic trick at a historical spot, is the type of skating Yuto displays, particularly in this part, that invokes a jaw-dropping reaction unlike what is normally experienced when watching a typical skate video. The last single shot of the part is Yuto's ender.
Duh.
And he keeps things interesting by masking up with a $300+ Moncler balaclava / neck warmer before proceeding to nollie 270 switchback lip down the famous Hollywood High School 16-stair handrail skate spot located near the corner of Hawthorne and North Highland Avenue. Best Banger Award. How do you choose a best trick from this part? There's so much heaviness in such a short amount of time, and Yuto does every trick so easily. In terms of significance, the ender is probably going to go down as the trick people remember from this part. He woke up and did this trick at 7 o'clock in the morning, and while I don't really f*** with fashion, it's notable that he did this trick wearing an expensive kit, including the Moncler ski mask, Thrasher Time Supreme sweater, and the SB Dunk Low J-Pack Chicagos, let alone whatever belt and Levi's he's wearing. Do without award. Was there anything in this part that didn't need to be there? Trick-wise, I think everything is immaculate, so I don't have criticism in that department. If I were still in my early 20s, picking a song about f***ing and consuming recreational substances would for sure be on the top of my playlist of tracks to skate to. But given the amount of visibility Yuto's going to have after being the Olympic gold medalist, I think this song choice was a misstep. The beat is dope as f***. Future can rap, no doubt, and the fact that they picked a track from 5 years ago is better than blindly choosing whatever top 10 trap hit is streaming on Spotify today. But the first lyrics you hear in Fly Sh** Only is about substance abuse. I take my drugs and doses. And I don't know if that's exactly the message we should encourage a potential SOTY to infect kids' brains with. But who gives a f*** what I think about it? This is skateboarding after all, and this part took place in the streets at real spots, where Yuto dodged security and San Francisco traffic. Let him pick whatever song he wants. I personally would have been stoked on a different song choice, or maybe a trap instrumental without the distracting lyrics. Mark Suciu. Mark deserves a turn in the spotlight for how much work he put into his skating this year. I don't currently have time to log all of his tricks from all of his parts this year, but it's no question his footage volume completely outweighs the 6 to 7 minutes of street skating Yuto released. Hopefully the stars can align for Suciu and he'll get SOTY another year, or maybe he'll walk away with the title this year, but I'll be surprised if he beats Yuto, the Olympic champ, in 2021. If you enjoyed these top takeaways from Yuto Horigome's Spitfire video, be sure to check out some of the other part breakdowns on my channel. Thanks again for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe to Dumb Data, click the notification bell to stay on top of new episodes, and drop a like if you enjoyed this breakdown. See you on the next dumb episode.